Hello, Internet, and welcome back to the data science community. So now that our predictive model is live and in the cloud and waiting for some questions, let's ask it some questions and see what it thinks. Today, we'll be adapting Python code to submit new datasets to our web service to obtain predictions. If you saw our previous video on how to submit calls to your web service using R code, then you can go ahead and skip the first half of this video where I explain the Azure ML API and go directly to the Python portion of this video by clicking on the orange annotation at the bottom right-hand corner of the screen. This tutorial will assume you already deployed a predictive web service. If you want to know how to create a model, click here. If you want to learn how to deploy a model, click here. You also need a text editor to work with Python code. I recommend Sublime Text2 or PyCharm. I'll be using Sublime for this video. The first thing we need to do is mark our deployed web service as ready for production. So once you're in Azure ML, you click on web service, and that will take you to a list of the web service that you have. And last time we deployed Titanic model-deployed web service. You want to click on that, and that'll take you to your web deployment screen. So once you're in your web deployment screen, click on configure, and in the configuration screen, this is where you can set up the documentation for your API. And you don't have to do this, but I've gone ahead and labeled each of the descriptions for good style. By the way, if you're on this screen and you don't see an input schema or an output schema, it means that your model is not ready to be deployed. It probably means you're either missing an input or an output, or you don't have a schema in your deployed model. So once you're satisfied with all your documentation, just go up and mark your web service as ready for deployment. And by switching this switch from no to yes, and by it being on yes, your web service is now live. The next thing you want to do is save your changes. Click on the save button below to solidify your documentation and the status change from not ready to ready for production. The next thing we'll want to do is we want to go grab our code to ping our API. So you want to go back to the dashboard by clicking on dashboard, and that'll bring you back to your deployment dashboard. You'll notice that there's an API key ready for you to be copied. You will need this to open up a connection to your API. Every web service will have its own unique API key, and this is how you keep your connection secure, so don't share this unless you want someone to actually use it. For this video, I've generated a fake API key to demonstrate to you where the key goes, but when it comes to actually making an API call, I will be censoring the real API key. So go ahead and click the copy button on the right hand side here, and it'll copy it to your clipboard. And then I'm going to open up Sublime and just copy and paste it in here for now. So we're going to use this as a staging error for now. Now that we have our key, let's go grab our code. Azure has pre-generated some sample code that we can use to easily adapt to our own uses. To get that code, we have to click on the API help page under the entry where it says request and response. So click on that link. Now that you're on the API request page, you will start to see a lot of code, but don't worry, don't panic. I'll walk you through it. First thing of interest will be your post request URL. This URL will be inserted into your pre-generated code already, so don't worry about it too much. It's just if you're a veteran programmer and you want to set up your own custom post calls, you will need this URL and the API key and the dataset parameters, and you're good to go. You'll also notice that Azure ML supports JSON formats. Moving on, you see the request body. And look, the documentation we gave earlier is here. And also our input schema is here, and it tells you exactly what the JSON key names are and what the variable types you'll be expecting. By the way, case matters, so this is all case sensitive. And that's why I didn't capitalize male or female on the description, but I did capitalize C, Q, and S for the embarked attributes. And behold, this is the JSON input, and this is the format that the API expects your questions to be asked if it is to be given a prediction. Then there's the response body, same style as your request body, but notice that there's two extra entries, scored label and score probabilities. These will be your predictions. Lastly is our sample response. This is a preview of a blank request. If you do not see this, or if this sample response is blank, it means your web service is not ready. I would go back to your model and check the inputs, the outputs, and the schema. And lastly is our pre-generated code. It supports C#, Python, and R. I'll be showing you how to adapt the Python code. And this code's been pre-generated exactly and uniquely for our web service. You just need to add your API key and add the datasets you want it to score and predict. So let's copy and paste this into our text editor. For me, I'll be using Sublime. So just paste that in. Currently, my Sublime is configured to read Python. Now we have to modify our code. Let's start by placing our API key in the proper position. So go ahead and cut your API key. Now scroll down and you'll notice that your pre-generated code already tells us where the API key should go. So just paste that there within the quotes. Next thing is we want to give it some test parameters. So I'll use the same parameters I did in the last video, which returned a 0 for not survived and a 40% chance of survival. So third class, I am a male, age 24, one spouse, no kids, $20 for a fare, and embarked from port C. And we're done. With that, we can copy and paste our code into Python. So I'm going to open up my Python console. And you can't use Control V to copy and paste into Python console, or else you'll get the literal keystroke for it. So what you have to do is you have to left click on this icon right up here, go to edit, and then go to paste. And then that'll paste in your API. And look at that, there's our return prediction. So it predicted that I would have a 40% chance of survival, and it casted that as no, I would not survive. So that is the answer that we should have gotten. And just to be sure, let's go back and let's do something fun. Let's change my sex to female and copy and paste that in once again and see what we get. And we're keeping all the other parameters the same. So we're just seeing how big of a factor gender played in surviving the Titanic disaster. Look at that. So by changing my sex from male to female, I increased my survival chance by 17%, and it casted me as I would survive. And that's it. You just concluded the tutorial on how to obtain predictions from your web service.
If you like what you just saw, subscribe to our channel or leave us a comment. Let us know if there's a topic you want us to cover, and be sure to check us out at datasciencedojo.com. Until next time.